Hi there, Holli here from HolliDay Anyday. You know, many of us think about pizza ovens and the only thing you can do in a pizza oven is savory dishes. Well, I'm going to tell you you're wrong. You can actually do sweet dishes. When we bought our pizza oven, we were fortunate enough to be able to actually go to the factory in Bellingham, Washington and meet with the chef and learn all the different things we can do in the pizza oven. He cooked lamb chops. He cooked pizza. He cooked roasted vegetables. He cooked bananas foster, which is to die for. So what I came up with the other day, I thought, well, what the heck? What about strawberries? Because strawberries are fabulous right now. So what we did was, I thought, well, let's cook some strawberries in the pizza oven. How to do that best? I didn't want to use a Pyrex pan because I was afraid it would, you know, explode in the pizza oven. So what I did was, I got my cast iron pan, pop it in the pizza oven for maybe 10 minutes, 15 minutes to get it really, really, really hot. So it's in there right now. In the meantime, we cut up some strawberries, just take the tops off, cut them in half. To the strawberries, we're going to add the zest of one orange. If I zested a bit of it, we can finish that up, show you what's what here. I think you could probably add Grand Marnier or something like that, but I was afraid it might catch on fire because the pizza oven's so hot, so I didn't want to risk it. So, basically just the zest of one orange. It's real simple. And then we're going to throw in 3 tablespoons of a chunky sugar. I like demerara sugar. It's just a little chunky and crunchy. I think brown sugar would probably be just fine. So all we're going to do is toss that up. Super simple. Now, like I was mentioning, my cast iron pan has been heating. So now let me pull it out. And like I said, it's crazy, crazy hot. So we gotta be super duper careful. Put my little glove on. Very careful. It is smoking. To the pan. Let's add our strawberries. You can hear them sizzling and smoking as they hit that pan. Oh my goodness. Smells so good. Now, back into the pizza oven. Now I'm going to leave it up in the front because the oven, of course, is hotter in the back because the flames are in the back. I'm going to leave it in the front and move it around probably for 5 to 10 minutes, and then we'll pull it out and I'll show you what we're going to serve it over. Okay, it's been about maybe 10 minutes. I think our strawberries are ready to roll. Check this out. Be so careful. Now, I'm going to put this over ice cream. You can put it over all kinds of things. Someone today mentioned on toast, you can put it with ricotta cheese. So we've got some fabulous yummy ice cream. What I'm going to do is, oh, look at that, sizzle, sizzle, sizzle. It's going to melt the ice cream immediately. Oh, does that look yum aroma? Oh my goodness. It's still bubbling away as I put over the ice cream. This was a couple pints, so maybe enough for like 4 people. To that, I'm going to add some homemade cornmeal biscotti. The recipe is on our website. We also do have a video on how to make this. It's very good, very crunchy and rustic, which works out really good with the mushy soft ice cream because you need some crunch. Then, because we want to be fancy, we're going to put some of our mint that we got from our garden this morning. And there you go. Dessert and pizza oven. Easy breezy.